Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri, and today I'm going to talk about resource hierarchy in Google Cloud. If you are working in a Google Cloud project or if you want to go for a Google Cloud certification, this is a very important topic that you should know. This is something that is part of identity and access management in Google Cloud. I highly recommend you to please watch this entire video so that you understand the resource hierarchy concept in Google Cloud. In this video, I'm going to talk about organizations, folders, subfolders, projects, and resources. In future, I will be publishing more videos on Google Cloud. So if you want to know about my upcoming videos, I will request you to please subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, please hit the like icon and share with your friends and families. So without any further delay, let's jump in. So let's understand resource hierarchy in Google Cloud. To understand, here is an example. For example, I have a bank called ABCD Bank. At the top of the structure, we have this bank ABCD, and that's called the organization. Under that organization, we have multiple sectors. Like, for example, we have public sectors, private sectors, and private forex. So these are individually in Google Cloud. We call them as folders. So under organization, we will have folders. So under folders, we may have subfolders, which is basically under private sectors. Maybe we have a local and foreign. So these are called, in Google Cloud terminology, we call them as subfolders. And then comes each folders or each subfolders can have their own environment. For example, you can see in the screen, we have dev, UAT, and production. And this is to make sure we have different environments to support the development of this entire project. So in Google Cloud terminology, we call them as projects. And under projects, we have the Google Cloud resources. So Google Cloud resources can be a Google Cloud virtual machine. It can be an Apigee server. It can be Cloud SQL. It can be anything. So resources are part of a project. And each project can have different type of resources. Though in this screen, you can see I have three projects, which is basically three environments, dev, UAT, and prod. And each of them have the similar kind of resources, but in your implementation, you can have different resources in different environment. For example, prod and UAT, which makes more sense to have more resources, for example, integration heavy. But in dev, we probably don't need all the resources. So we can cut down resources in the dev environment, which is basically a dev project, and bring those resources in UAT and prod. And that is the way how you can reduce your billing in by not utilizing the resources which are not necessary in lower environment. For example, dev, or if you have staging in those environments, you probably don't need those resources. You can cut down those and you can put those resources back in UAT and prod where you definitely need them, because each resources are costly. Whatever resources that you will use, based on that, your Google Cloud billing will be. So if you don't need the resources, it doesn't make sense to use that in that environment. With that, IAM policy is basically a set of permissions which are applied at the organization level, or it can be applied in here on the folder level, subfolder level, projects, or there are some IAM policies which will be applied at the resources level. I am going to publish a dedicated video on the IAM policies, what are the different type of policies, because I don't want to mix the IAM policy with this resource hierarchy video, because it's a separate topic and it's a quite a big topic which demands a separate video. But just to understand at a very high level, policies can be applied on each of these layers, starting from organization to folders, subfolders, projects, and resources. And once a policy or once a permission is applied at the top level, it follows the top-down approach. It actually goes to the down resources or down sections, right, in the hierarchy. For example, if a policy is applied at the organization level, the same policy will be automatically applied at the folder, subfolder, projects, or the resources level. You can't delete a policy which is being applied at the top level, but definitely you can override the policy. So with that, let's go for a demo. So here I am in my Google Cloud console. So the first thing that I'll be doing, I'll be creating a project. So there are multiple ways you can create the project. One is from this drop down, you can find out all your projects. So currently I have only one project, which is Technical Potpourri, but you can create multiple projects. So I'm going to create a project here. So the way to create a project, click on this new project and then give a name like this project. Now, if you remember, project should be part of an organization, right? So we have this organization at the top, followed by folders, subfolders, and then projects, and then what is called resources, right? But since I am using a free version of the Google Cloud, I am not allowed to create an organization and as well as folders, because if I go and click here, it will show that I have no organizations. The reason is that because I'm using a free Google Cloud console. So this is the Google documentation which tells that organization resource is available for the Google Cloud if you are a Google Cloud workspace or a cloud identity customer. If you are one of these two, then you can create your organization, you can create your folders, subfolders, and all these things. But since I'm using a Google Cloud free version, I cannot use that. But what I'm trying to show you here is that you can create a project and then you can click on create, which will create this new project. Here at the bell icon, it will show you what it's doing. It's basically creating the project right now. In a few minutes, the project will be created. As you can see, the project is created. And the moment the project is created, I can click on this select project to go to my new project. So this is one way. Another way is the old fashioned way is click on this drop down and it will show you all the projects. You can choose whatever project you want to go. For example, currently I am in the test project because I can see the tick sign. But if I want to go to the technical Potpourri project, I can just click on this one and it will take me to the project. So another thing that you need to understand or you need to remember that if you are using the Google Cloud free version, the maximum number of projects that you can create, I think, is 24. So yes, I can still create, actually it's 25, because if I create this project, then I'll be having 3 projects in my Google Cloud and I can still create 22. So it means I can, with the free version, I can create 25 projects. One more thing that you need to remember, once a project is created, this is the project name and this is the project ID. Project name is not a unique field. So even after creating the project, you can change the project name. But this ID is basically an immutable ID and it's a unique ID. You cannot change this value. And this is something that you need to remember because there may be some questions that you'll get in the Google Cloud certification. And with that, we have come to an end. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. In next video, I'm going to talk about IAM policies and what are the different IAM policies that are available, what are their differences, how we can use that. Yeah, keep your eyes open. And if you are subscribed, you'll get notification automatically the moment I publish that video. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.